Liver, yes, you're right. Here and here, which peduncle of cerebellum?
Inferior.
That is?
Middle.
Here it is?
Superior.
Between superior peduncles, here it is?
Medularis
superior. Good. What are that? That is midbrain, it is midbrain, that is lamina tecti, and upper surface of lamina tecti has quadrigerminal caliculus, that is superior caliculus, and here it is
inferior
caliculus. From inferior caliculus start brachium, here it is brachium of inferior caliculus, and it go to geniculate body, here it is medial, and that is lateral. Here it is corpus geniculatum mediale and corpus geniculatum laterale. That is subcortical medial body together with inferior caliculus subcortical auditory center and lateral geniculate body together with superior caliculus subcortical visual center. Very clear to see triangle, trigonum limnisce, look here. Trigonum limnisce posteriorly formed with the help of what? Superior peduncles of cerebellum. Then anteriorly, that is brachium of caliculi inferioris. And lower part, that is pedunculi cerebri here. Or sulcus lateralis mesencephali. That is triangle, trigonum limnisce. And it has surname because it is what? Limniscus. Lateralis, lateral limniscus pass. And this triangle, it is part of what? What is department of brain has trigonum limniscus? Isthmus rhombencephali. Isthmus rhombencephali. Superior peduncles, velum medullare, and triangle trigonum limniscus together from isthmus rhombencephali. Well, next we continue, and today we will speak about diencephalon. Diencephalon. Diencephalon subdivides into two, thalamencephalon and hypothalamus. And thalamencephalon subdivides into thalamus, epithalamus, and metathalamus. Thalamus has egg shape, that is thalamus. Anterior part of the thalamus is has name tubercle, tuberculum anterior. Posterior wide part of the thalamus has name pulvinar. Here it is. That is dorsal surface. Here it is medial surface. Here it is opposite thalamus. And medial surfaces of thalamus formed lateral walls of the third ventricle. Space between thalamus, that is third ventricle. Next, we will speak a lot about nuclei of thalamus. Now, only what we can see on preparates. Between medial surfaces of thalamus, sometimes we can see adhesio, that is commissura, adhesio interthalamica, it's joined together both thalamus. Adhesio interthalamica, that is part of this adhesio, you can see here. Here it is, adhesio interthalamica. Next. Epithalamus. Epithalamus consists of triangle, trigonum habenule, that is trigonum habenule. From this triangle start habenule, just a moment. That is triangle, trigonum habenule, here it is habenule, and habenule go to pineal body, here it is should pineal body, that is absent, maybe, no. No, there is absent. Should be small gland, endocrine gland, between superior tubercles of midbrain, here it is, and name of this gland, pineal body or epiphyses, pineal body. And habenula go to pineal body, and between two habenula we can see commissura. That is commissura habenularum. I draw you a diagram after my explanation on preparates. One again, epithalamus consists of triangle trigonum habenulare, habenula and commissura habenularum, and it is epiphyses. Epiphyses. Next, metathalamus. I already said that metathalamus include two geniculate body, corpus geniculatum mediale and corpus geniculatum laterale. Medial geniculate body joint with inferior caliculus, lateral geniculate body joint with superior caliculus. That is thalamencephalon, thalamus, epithalamus, and metathalamus. Now, below of thalamencephalon, we can see hypothalamus. Hypothalamus has two departments, anterior and posterior. Anterior part has name optic part. It includes optic nerve, that is second cranial nerve, optic nerve, then optic chiasma, chiasma opticum, and optic tract. And also here it is tuber cinereum. Tuber cinereum together with infundibulum and hypophysis. Do you know what is hypophysis? Yes. What is it? Pituitary gland. That is, it's arise from tuber cinereum together with infundibulum. All of the structures, optic nerve, optic chiasma, optic tract, tuber cinereum and infundibulum, it is more better to see tuber cinereum. It is tuber cinereum, and from this tuber start infundibulum, and infundibulum go to hypophysis. Why impossible to see hypophysis on preparate? Because where it's situated in cella turcica, and dorsum of cella turcica it's protect hypophysis, and when we remove brain from the skull, cella turcica is impossible to remove brain together with hypophysis. It's always broken because cella turcica not give us possibility to remove brain together with hypophysis. That is anterior hypothalamus, optic nerve, optic chiasma, optic tracts, tuber cinereum and infundibulum together with hypophysis. That is anterior or optic hypothalamus. Posterior part or olfactory part, it include mammillary bodies, corpora mammillaria, and behind of them regio hypothalamica posterior together with substantia perforata posterior. Posterior perforated substance, substantia perforata posterior. You can see a lot of small openings here in posterior regions. Through these openings, vessels pass to posterior region of hypothalamus. Posterior perforated substance, substantia perforata posterior, here it is. Corpora mammillaria, posterior hypothalamic region, and substantia perforata posterior. All of the structures in posterior part of hypothalamus or olfactory part. And last moment on preparate, that is third ventricle. Third ventricle, that is a space between thalamus. Medial surface of thalamus formed lateral walls of the third ventricle. Posterior wall, it is epithalamus, commissura habenularum, pineal body, and below of commissura habenularum we can see, oh, here it is maybe, yes, look here, that is thalamus, here it is thalamus, that is lateral wall of the third ventricle, thalamus. Next, posteriorly, here it is commissura habenularum, and then commissura cerebri posterior here. Commissura habenularum superiorly, commissura cerebri posterior inferiorly. And below of this commissura cerebri posterior, we can see opening. Here it is opening of what? That is midbrain And what is the cavitas of midbrain? Aqueduct. Heat is aqueduct. Aqueduct. It's communicate what? What is it? Fourth ventricle, then aqueduct, and heat is third ventricle. Clear? Okay. And again, posterior wall of the third ventricle has commissura habenularum, commissura cerebri posterior. Between them, heat is recessus pineale, and below of commissura cerebri posterior heat is opening of aqueduct. That is posterior wall. Now, superior wall. Superior wall heat is telecharaida. You can see it. That is telecharaida. Heat is telecharaida. And telecharaida is below of fornix. Heat is fornix. Fornix. And below of fornix, telecharaida. And above of fornix, corpus callosum. Heat is corpus callosum. That is superior wall of the third ventricle. Now, anterior wall. Anterior wall of the third ventricle include, that is fornix, and fornix continue into columna fornices. Here it is columna fornices. Columna fornices, in front of columna fornices, we can see lamina terminalis, and also should be commissura cerebri anterior. Heat is not so clear to see. Only columna fornices and lamina terminalis we can see. And between anterior wall and thalamus, we can see opening, and this opening communicate third ventricle with lateral ventricle, ventriculus lateralis. Ventriculus lateralis, heat is. What we can see here, that is columna fornices, that is anterior surface of thalamus, and space between columna fornices and thalamus, that is foramen interventriculare, here left foramen, and here it is right, and both of them communicate third ventricle with lateral ventricle, here and here, that is foramen interventriculare. Two openings on anterior wall of the third ventricle. Next, inferior wall. Inferior wall, that is hypothalamus. Hypothalamus formed inferior wall of the third ventricle, and here it is, we have two recessus. Recessus opticus in the region of chiasma opticum, and recessus infundibuli in the region of infundibulum. Sorry. What we can see here, that is thalamus, and here it is opposite thalamus. Why we cannot to see here third ventricle? Because here it is fornix. If we remove this fornix, under the fornix, we will see telecharaida, and below of telecharaida, we will see third ventricle. Clear? And here it is, you can see foramen interventriculare. That is foramen interventriculare. It's communicate lateral ventricle with third ventricle. Here, and here it is, foramen interventriculare between lateral ventricle and third ventricle. Is it clear?
Yes.
So. Well. I think that is all what we can see, but stay here it is and give me a piece of paper. I want to draw something. And somebody brings this preparation to classroom number 6. Yes, 6 classes.